Welcome to the MAXQDA Getting Started video tutorial. As the title suggests, this video will teach you everything you need to know to get started with MAXQDA in just a few minutes. The first thing MAXQDA will ask you to do is enter a username, which is important if you're working in Teams. You can then either open an existing project or create a new one, which is what I'm going to do right now. The MAXQDA project file is like a container that includes all the elements of your analysis and, in most cases, all of your data. After creating a project, you don't need to save your progress over and over again, since MAXQDA does that automatically, following every single action you perform. The first thing you'll see is this four-window interface, which is one of MAXQDA's most popular characteristics because it's just so straightforward. It's so straightforward, in fact, you can explain it in one sentence. You organize your data here, view and categorize it here, manage your categories, which are called codes in MAXQDA, here, and later on you can retrieve the segments you have coded here. Simple, right? So, let's get started. First of all, we want to import some data. So let's take a closer look at the document system. MAXQDA offers numerous ways to import your data. The easiest is to go to the Import tab. You can really import almost anything into MAXQDA. In addition to texts, PDFs, tables, images, and media documents, you can also find special import options for transcripts, surveys, tweets, websites, and more. I'll go with the standard documents import for now. To select more than one item, just hold down the Shift button when you click them. And now they're imported. Another quick way is to simply drag and drop them from Windows Explorer or Mac Finder into the document system. Now that we've imported these interviews, we might want to organize them a bit first. And the easiest way to do this is to use these folders right here, which we call document groups in MAXQDA. You might like to use them to organize your data by data type. To save time, we can activate documents by clicking on this little gray circle here, and afterwards moving all of the activated documents at once like this. A document can only be part of one document group. If you want to organize your data in more than one respect, document sets are the way to go, because every document can be part of an unlimited number of document sets. Simply activate the documents you want to group in a new set, then right-click on Document Sets and select New Set. Of course, these are only the most rudimentary ways to organize your data. As I'll show you in another tutorial, you can also use the data editor and document variables to efficiently target and organize particularly large amounts of data. If there's some information you want to remember, or you have a thought about any single document, document group, or set that you wish to hold on to, then double-click in this column here to add a memo and simply write it down. Now that you know the basics of importing and organizing your data, let's dive into one of our interviews by opening it via a double click in the document browser, or if you want to make use of a second monitor, you can also open it in a new window. The main use of the document browser is to read and code data. So the default mode for this window prevents you from changing your text unintentionally. In order to change the content or layout of a text document, you need to turn on the edit mode, right here. And then you get several options to change the format of your text to your liking and add or delete something. But as I just said, this window is mainly used for coding. So let's do that. First, I highlight the segment I want to code. And then I click on this button here to create a new code. Now I can enter a name for my new code, choose a code color, and add a description. After clicking on OK, we see a little coding stripe here that marks the coded segment. By right-clicking in this area, you get different options to determine which codes get displayed and how. But I'll let you figure out the details for yourself. To adjust the boundaries of this segment afterwards, just highlight the segment again, right-click on the coding stripe, and select Recode with Highlighted Segment. MAXQDA also lets you code in Vivo. This means that MAXQDA uses the coded text itself as the name for your newly created code. You can also specify a certain weight for a coded segment to distinguish it from other coded segments, or add a comment to the segment like this. And you can also easily add memos anywhere in your text by double-clicking in this column here. When we go down to our third window now, we can see the code that we have just created listed in the code system, with a memo that contains its description. We can also add new codes right here with this button, and order our code system hierarchically down to 10 levels. Now that we've coded some data, we can see those numbers here and here. They tell us how many coded segments can be found in the respective document or code. As you can see, collapsing a parent code will display the total number of coded segments, including those of all your subcodes. If you want more detailed information about your code system, switch to the table view here. This allows you to filter and organize your codes much more quickly if there are a lot of them. Once we've applied a number of codes to our data, we might want to retrieve the coded segments so that we can look at them individually. The procedure is very simple. Just activate the documents you want to take into account, then activate the codes from which you want to retrieve the respective coded segments. With the default simple coding query in place, all the coded segments will be displayed in the retrieved segments window. Of course, this is only the simplest coding query you can do with MAXQDA, so check out the complex coding queries if you have something more advanced in mind. You can see here that there's a little info box for every segment. These provide us with some information like where this segment can be found or which weight score has been assigned to it. Clicking on the info box will display the original passage in the document browser. This way you can quickly and easily see your retrieved segments in their original context. By switching to the table view, you can once again target specific segments much more precisely. To save these results for later use, just code them with a new or an already existing code. And if you're tired of looking at a screen all day, you can always print your coded segments or your documents just as they are. Or click on the export icon to produce an Excel table that contains all of the relevant information. Pretty handy, isn't it? Now you know the basics of working with MAXQDA. So what's next? Well, depending on your research project, you might like to check out the lexical search to search for words and automatically code the results. Or you might like to get yourself acquainted with MAXQDA's visualization tools, which can be found up here. They're easy to use and offer incredible insights into code occurrences and code relationships. And where can you learn about all this, you ask? Well, you can find tons of video tutorials on our website or on YouTube. We have a very comprehensive and well-arranged online manual, an active forum for you to ask questions, and a very dedicated support team to come to your aid in case you run into any trouble. You can also join the MAXQDA Research Network to get all the latest news on qualitative and mixed methods research, search for professional trainers or workshops on our website, or even become a trainer yourself. And if you like Europe in the springtime, come and join us at our annual user conference, the MQIC in Berlin. Until then, all the best with your project.